sense of this situation at all.
What's he doing down here?
He's got him right here. What an athlete for Rotunda to kick out of the situation.
Again, Steiner had him down. He had him for the count. And there's that belly suplex. And there's the bell.
And what happened? Williams rang the bell. The match is not over.
No.
It's not over, Teddy.
Dr. Death, Steve Williams rang that bell.
I don't have...
No.
Teddy, the timekeeper did not ring the bell. We've seen this happen before. Steiner thinks he's won the match.
The referee is saying that the time is... Now we got another referee down here ringside, Tommy Young.
Senior referee Tommy Young is out here. And he is asking Gary Capetta if he rang the bell. He did not.
Now the two referees are going to confer over this.
Rotunda wants his belt. Steiner thinks he's won it.
And while they were talking and discussing it, Kevin Sullivan, the cage, was lowered, and Sullivan is out of the cage and now up on the apron of the ring.
I guess the keeper of the cage thought the match was over, too. A lot of confusion right here. And he's called. He said the bell.
He said wrestle.
He said to start it over. Sullivan.
And Magnum, what an exciting moment to see Rick Steiner run around that ring after winning the title.
That's what it's all about. That's the excitement of Starrcade. Nothing gets any better than that. Rick Steiner took the man down for 1-2-3, and that is what NWA's finest wrestling action is all about.
One more time. Here it is. You see Teddy Long saying, continue the match. Mike Rotunda knew what to do. He slugged the man. An irate Kevin Sullivan grabbing Tommy Young, and at the right moment, here you go. Down goes both men.
It's great to see, despite all odds, he came out on top. The interference didn't get it done.
So there it is, your new World Television Champion, Rick Steiner. And he's your winner. You know, we said 0 for 2. The champion so far, we still have three major titles to be decided here coming up.
That's right, Tony. Think about it. We've seen two major title changes. Nobody was calling for them because it's always in the champion's favor. We've got the U.S. title coming up. Bam Bam Bigelow, that big challenge he's pursuing. We all know Lex Luger is gunning for the World's Heavyweight Championship. I mean, anything can happen. This is Starrcade. This is when the magic takes place. This is what it's all about.
That's a good point. You know, Bam Bam Bigelow, for the magic to work for him, I would think within the first 10 minutes of the match, he would have to beat Barry Windham, because the longer you go, the better Barry Windham gets.
Well, ordinarily, I'd say you're right, but Bam Bam Bigelow, 396 pounds or not, his heart has got to be in this match more than he's ever had in his career. And I look for Bam Bam to maybe be able to go 20, 25 minutes, even 30 minutes if he has to. Anything to get that title.
Magnum then following that for the World Tag Team title, the Road Warriors against Dusty and Sting. And I really think you don't have to worry about winners or losers in this. I think you're going to have to talk about survivors when it comes down to this tag team match.
Well, if there's anybody I know in this sport, this is survivors, American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I see him just back up against the wall. I see him against all odds. And this man's not going down to anybody, certainly not the Road Warriors.
Bam Bam is making his way to the ring, and then Ric Flair, the man who means Starrcade, will come on against Lex Luger.